Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at using VoiceOver in iMovie. So I'm using iMovie 10. We're going to take a look at VoiceOver. So say you've got some video here. I've got some sample clips and a sample project, and you want to basically narrate what's going on. You want to add some audio here using the microphone built into your Mac or one you have connected to it. You can do that using the VoiceOver function. The way to find that is go to Window and Record VoiceOver, and then you'll get a special microphone here and it will react to your voice. You could also select some options, so the input source, volume, and such. And then at any time you want, you could start recording. And it's important to position the playback head where you want it to be, and then it will start recording your voice and adding it as a track here. So to start recording, press the microphone and it will count down. And notice the playback head jumps back, and when it gets to zero, it's right where you want it to be. And notice that it's recording my voice here and adding this track to the bottom as I talk. And then when I'm all done, I can hit the VoiceOver button again and it'll stop. And there you go. There you see my voice is recorded in there. I could add other pieces of VoiceOver somewhere else. So if I wanted to start talking here, I could. I could treat this just like a regular piece of sound. I could select it and delete it if I want, or change the volume, put a sound curve in there to lower and raise the volume at different portions. I could also edit this. See, I've got both. There's both sound editing here, where it's already preset for lower the volume of other clips so you can hear my voice, and also the equalizer is turned on to voice enhance. I can change that to something else, and I can even set reduce background noise on. So there's a lot you can do here with the simple VoiceOver, and it's great to be able to narrate what you're doing. Also, if you're using iMovie to create a photo slideshow, you could basically narrate the photo slideshow and then export it that way, which is a little bit nicer of a slideshow than you might normally get exporting from a photo app.